This is the first of two videos where we look at how Leica Captivate handles the importing and use of data from a DXF file. Leica Captivate actually has two methods for this, a basic importing method and a more sophisticated attaching method. In this first video, we will look at the more basic importing method, where it imports an entire CAD file as one into a chosen job. We'll start by ensuring that a suitable data file exists. In this example, we'll use a file called houseplot.dxf. As we can see here in AutoCAD, this is a drawing that contains the outline plans of a house. In order to use this file, we need to make sure that it's saved into the data folder of one of our memory devices. We can now take a look at what happens when we import this entire DXF file as one into one of our jobs. We first pick which job we want to use and make sure it's in the center of the job carousel, and then we tap it to turn it around and access the job menu. And then from here, we select Import Data. Different videos look at the various options within this import list. However, this video is focusing specifically on DXF, so we will select that option. We then have to tell Leica Captivate which memory device and which file we would like to import. Here, we'll use the SD card and the houseplot DXF. We can then see that the job is the one we selected, and we could then press OK to import it. However, first, we shall check the settings by pressing Function and then Settings, allowing us to configure how Leica Captivate will import the DXF data. The first three settings allow us to apply a prefix to the ID of any elements that will be imported from DXF, which is very useful as it makes them much easier to identify. Next, we can confirm the units used within the CAD file. Then, we can select if we would like to create points at the vertices, or key points, of lines and polylines. A very useful feature if our DXF file contains mainly lines and polylines, but we'd like to stake individual points. Next, we have an option to convert white elements to black. Then, we have the option to exclude a certain height, meaning that any data within the DXF file with the specified height value would have that height ignored and would be imported as 2D data. And then the final option is essentially the reverse of this, where any data that is 2D in the DXF file would have a height applied to it upon import. With these settings done and understood, we can press OK to close this window and then press OK again to begin the import. Once the import is complete, Leica Captivate will provide us with a summary of what has been imported, and it also asks if we would like to import any more data. In this case, we don't need to, so we can simply tap No. To see how this imported data looks, we can enter into the 3D viewer. Here, we can see all the points, lines, arcs, circles, and polylines from the DXF file imported into our job. As we zoom in and pan around, we can not only see the points and lines that were in our DXF, but we can also see all of these additional points that have been created at the vertices of our lines. This straightforward method of importing an entire DXF file straight into our job is very useful if we want to interact with every single point and line from the DXF file. However, this method does not allow us to switch different parts of the DXF file on and off, making use of CAD layers. And also, there are some elements that are not supported by this method, such as text. So, in effect, this method can be thought of as a really quick and easy way to get all of the points and lines from a DXF format into one of our jobs. But if we would like to do something a bit more sophisticated and give ourselves more options and more power, such as being able to view more DXF entities, being able to see the text from a DXF file, and having layer management control, then we can use the alternative method of attaching a DXF to a job. And this is exactly what the second of these two DXF videos will cover.